The impeachment trial of the 45th President of the United States, President Donald Trump, is likely to come to a close soon.
Our focus right now is on getting the 4 votes.
Late Thursday evening, a key Republican senator, Lamar Alexander, gave a blow to Democrats. He announced that he will not vote to call witnesses in Trump's impeachment trial, paving the way for Senate Republicans to acquit the president. Senator Lisa Murkowski, another potential swing voter, made a similar announcement Friday. Democrats needed Alexander's vote and at least 3 other Republicans to vote with them to call on trial witnesses. On Friday, about 200 lawyers from across the country held a rally in front of the Supreme Court to protest Senate Republicans' actions in the impeachment trial. But the fight to remove President Trump from the White House is not over, according to political analyst Professor Alan Sanders.
We're now heading into is a campaign season, right? We have the presidential election coming up. We have congressional elections coming up. And that's really what it's all about. The Democrats have well known that getting witnesses or getting a guilt verdict out of the Senate would be very difficult to do, if not totally unlikely.
President Trump already reiterating much of his 2016 campaign promises during his campaign rally in Iowa on Thursday night, including making Mexico pay for the border wall.
Through remittance, illegal aliens from Mexico are going to pay for the wall. That's what it is.
Professor Sanders said while the president can get acquitted in the Senate, the impeachment issue would likely haunt him in the November elections. The first votes leading up to the 2020 presidential election will be held on Monday in Iowa. In 2016, President Trump won Iowa with more than 10% of the votes ahead of Hillary Clinton. Len Amadin Thornhill, ABS-CBN News.
Carving out enough time to go to